Good morning, and congratulations to the class of 2021. I would like to welcome all of you to the virtual University of California, Irvine, Paul Marad School of Business commencement ceremony, and to thank all the families and friends that have gathered this morning to celebrate the wonderful accomplishments of the 2021 graduates. Though we were not able to be in person this year, it is still right and fitting that we celebrate this tremendous accomplishment that makes this day special. To the class of 21, well done. You've officially completed your journey with the Marad School and can now join our alumni community of over 12,000 individuals spread across the United States and in over 36 countries. You have excelled and thrived under what can only be described as extraordinary circumstances and earned a degree that truly speaks to your work ethic, your dedication, and your commitment to excellence. I have only had the great privilege of serving as a dean of the Marad School for 6 months. Yet, I certainly understand the challenges you've overcome, and more importantly, the heights that you have achieved. Many of you have earned your degree while working multiple jobs, raising a family, quarantining under less than ideal circumstances. You've overcome glitchy Wi-Fi connections, and collectively, we've all become Zoom experts. As the very world before us has changed, despite all the chaos that was created, you made the decision to continue your education and to strive towards excellence. Class of 2021, you are the epitome of perseverance. Your education and newfound knowledge is something that no one will ever be able to take away from you. And certainly today is the commencement. It is the starting point for you to move on to even bigger and better things. Certainly, I remember with great fondness when I graduated with my undergraduate degree. Nothing on that day would have ever told me that I would be addressing you today as the dean of a business school. But certainly I know that path was started and formed through my educational experience. I know what my education has done for me and my family, and I can't wait to see what your education will do for you and yours. Now, no matter where you go, remember the lessons that this year has taught us. Yes, it has been very traumatic, but as we have coped and as we have dealt with this major health crisis of COVID, certainly all of us have learned the value of empathy, flexibility, patience, and compassion. I am confident it is those attributes that will enable all of us to be successful as we lead organizations, communities, and our families going forward. Congratulations on this fantastic accomplishment. We wish you all the best going forward, and please do make sure you stay in touch with your Marad community.
Dear class of 2021, it is my honor as the Associate Dean of Master's Programs at Marad to join you today to celebrate your graduation. Even though this year's event has to take place virtually without the usual hugs and handshakes, and even though circumstances in the past year may have made your journey here tougher than you had expected to be, the challenges you have overcome to get here today also make what you have accomplished all the more remarkable. Congratulations, MFIN, MIE, MPAT, and MSBA class of 2021. Close to 20% of you successfully completed the entirety of your program remotely from your home country while managing through different time zones. We have all marveled at the resilience and perseverance of your group. Several MSBA students participated in a hackathon to address important questions in helping people recover from the COVID-19 crisis. We are all so proud of your achievements. Every red light eventually turns green. As you start your next chapter, I hope that with the resilience and perseverance that marked the class of 2021, you envision ways to become the green light that will carry your businesses and communities to new heights. Congratulations, members of the class of 2021, and good luck to each and every one of you.
Congratulations, class of 2021. You are all truly models of resiliency and innovation. It is an honor to be here with you and share what I hope you feel are a few words of wisdom from my personal experience. You may be asking yourself, who is she and why is she our keynote speaker? To be honest, I asked myself very similar questions when I was invited to speak to you. But the more I thought about it, the more I realized I am a microcosm of all of you. I graduated from the Executive MBA program here at the Paul Mirage School of Business in 2020. Our last quarter was entirely virtual as a result of COVID. I know we have a mix of undergraduate and graduate students here today. You have done an amazing job completing your degree during this unprecedented time. A year that has thrown our lives into a whirlwind. But your education, as many of you have already experienced, is a significant bridge to new opportunities. Before I go on, I'm going to do for you what I do with my medical students. Tell you up front the big takeaways. These are the things that you need to remember and walk away with. Remember, opportunity, innovation, and resiliency. Let's get started. I'd like you to consider how a bridge can be a metaphor for the limitless opportunities that your Mirage degree offers you. I've learned that there are many bridges in life. Bridges that you find, bridges that you build, bridges that you cross, and bridges that you become. I grew up in South Central Los Angeles, raised by a single mom who immigrated from Mexico at the age of 16. She worked 2-3 jobs at a time to send me to a better school so I could go to college. My mom would always tell me, "When I'm gone, I won't leave you money, but I will leave you something worth a lot more, something that no one can ever take away from you, an education." For me, education has been the bridge to opportunities that my mother dreamed for me to have. Now, why a bridge? A bridge does many things. And if you think about the Golden Gate Bridge, it goes over water, it sways with the wind, but it's sturdy and resilient. My initial bridge took me out of South Central Los Angeles and into a whole new world, college. For some of the undergrads who also came from challenging backgrounds and are the first ones in your family to graduate from college, UCI may be your first bridge. Congratulations on taking that first step and making it across. I would ask all of you to remember to look back and extend a hand to those trying to get across that first bridge. I continued finding, building, and crossing bridges after finishing my medical degree, public health degree, and most recently, my MBA. I'm privileged that I can look back and see how I, as one person, can make a difference in bridging the practice of medicine and public health. My bridge brings the voice of a Latina woman who has personal experience in addressing the many of the challenges that we as a society are striving to address. As a public health professional, I've developed and promoted statewide and national programs designed to keep moms and babies healthy. So when I deliver a baby and hand them off to the new parents, those programs that I helped develop can continue touching the lives of my patients. If you're wondering why I pursued an MBA after already earning an MD and an MPH, the answer is simple. I have realized that my purpose in life is to connect people to their health. I had one more bridge to build. That is to bridge health with business and technology. This became clear to me when I saw my teenage son playing online games, and much to my chagrin, sometimes up to several hours at a time. But he wasn't the only one enjoying online games in my family. So was my 78-year-old mother. She loves Candy Crush. And that's when it hit me. Bringing together my education, training, and experience, I connected the dots. And it occurred to me that the time spent playing a game can be combined with learning about your health. My mom has high blood pressure, but to this day, she's not too sure what the numbers mean. The solution? To gamify health. And that's exactly what I did. And now I'm the CEO and founder of a company I named Gamify Health. I completed my MBA with an emphasis in entrepreneur and innovation, and used my MBA as the incubator for my startup. I could not have asked for a more supportive and inspiring environment. The first game we developed was COVIDblast.com. The timing was perfect to launch a game that could reinforce behaviors to avoid getting COVID. The current game we're developing and finalizing is Teen Mind Games. This game screens teenagers for depression and gets them the help they need. There is so much stigma and shame associated with depression, and getting help is not always easy. Little did I know, when we first started developing Teen Mind Games, that depression would more than double during the pandemic. I'm still crossing that entrepreneur bridge, the bridge that joins personal health and universal gaming. At times, it feels like this bridge is made of rope. It's wobbly, and standing upright is difficult. There have been times that I've almost fallen, but the networks and the support that the Mirage School provides me is pulling me across. I know some of you have completed your degree without having ever been on campus. I encourage you to continue building your Mirage alumni bridge, whether in person or virtually, and reach for the hand and encouragement that will help you cross your bridge. I know you can do it. Each one of you is a model of innovation. You have found ways to adapt. If someone would have told you a year ago, the entire world would be confined to their homes, and you would be learning virtually, working remotely in study groups, working from home, and your kids would be homeschooling 100% virtually, you would not have believed it. Nobody would have. But that's exactly what you did. Many schools struggled to go virtual. You benefited from the Mirage School's promise of leadership in a digitally driven world, and their early adoption of remote learning made it happen. When I was a student here, I was traveling a lot for work and going to professional meetings. I love the convenience of attending classes online. Many of us also benefited from virtual workouts. Peloton became a household name, not just a business case study where we were reviewing to see if they were a high-tech company or an exercise machine. And all of you develop creative ways to network and support each other. One of my personal favorite virtual networks is the Mirage Dean Leadership Circle, the Mirage alumni group that I encourage all of you to join. I participated on a couple of Zoom gatherings during the heart of the sheltering in place. We had people from all over the United States and the world. We were sharing stories and experiences, and it was great. And for a short while, I forgot we were in a pandemic and under quarantine. Each of you has stories of how you endured the pandemic, how you found ways to continue your lives, and how you coped with the loss of friends, acquaintances, and loved ones. And we will all laugh at the continuous, "You are muted, we can't hear you." each of you will have stories to share with the generations that follow. And now, as we see the light at the end of the tunnel, each of you can say that you survived and you showed just how resilient you are. The third and final takeaway that has been a huge source of my success is resiliency. According to the Merriam-Webster Dictionary, resiliency is the ability of something to return to its original size and shape after being compressed or deformed. Resiliency is needed to withstand challenges, and in our case, the challenge was COVID. Based on our home, health, and personal experience, the amount of compression and deformation varied from person to person. Many of us lost family members, friends, acquaintances, or a job. And some of us have been sick ourselves. For me, in the early days of the pandemic, it was the uncertainty of whether or not I would get COVID while working in the hospital and caring for patients. I was afraid for my family, not for me. I didn't want to bring the infection home to them. In the beginning, there was so much we didn't know. Keeping my family safe was my biggest priority. It was not always easy, though, when we had a shortage of personal protective equipment. But we all rose above our personal pandemic challenges, and you did it in addition to getting your degree. If you can get through this, which you did, you can get through anything. You have been stretched, and as a result, you are stronger. Your innovation and resiliency have gotten you to this point. But now, where does that lead you? Remember, innovation, resiliency, and opportunities that leverage your ability to bridge worlds are unexpected and priceless lessons you have earned along with your degree. You've heard my story. What will your story be? What bridges will you discover or create? There will continue to be times when you will sway, you will feel like you're going to be blown off that bridge. But remember, you are resilient and innovative, and more importantly, not alone. You are a member of the Mirage family. Zot, zot, zot. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Hello, MSBAs. Congratulations on this huge accomplishment. This has been a very challenging year for all of you, and I have been so impressed with your enthusiasm and engagement and resiliency throughout the year. It's been truly inspirational to be a part of that journey with all of you. I can't wait to see where you all go, and I wish you all the best as you transition to being the successful professionals. I know you all are. And remember, we are now pals for life, so please keep in touch and let me know if there is ever anything I can do to support you in your professional journey post-MSBA. And don't forget to submit those offers on the bridge. I will definitely hound you until you do. So, congratulations!
Class of 21, congratulations, you've made it. It's been a crazy year to say the least, but we've all made it to the finish line. You are now graduates of the Mirage School of Business. Best of luck to you moving forward. We look forward to seeing you back on campus soon as alumni, and good luck with everything as you move into your future endeavors. And rip-a-meters!
If you think back to just one short year ago, it's amazing to think about how much you've learned and accomplished over this past year. You should be extremely proud of how much you've grown both personally and professionally. I really want to take this opportunity to wish you the best in your future. I know that you guys are going to accomplish great things. Congratulations.
Congratulations, MSBA class of 2021. We are so proud of you. You have faced challenges this year and you have overcome them. We can't wait to see what you accomplish. Congratulations.
Congratulations, class of 2021. You did it, and now you have officially graduated from the MSBA program. Receiving your graduate degree is a big accomplishment, and you should feel incredibly proud. This year certainly wasn't an easy one, but you persevered and made it through. There will be ups and downs in life, but hopefully the knowledge you take from UCI and the Mirage School will stay with you for a lifetime and serve as a foundation for your future success. We look forward to staying in touch with you and seeing your career grow while celebrating your wins along the way. Once again, congratulations and zot, zot, zot.
Congratulations, class of 2021. I am so proud of all that you have accomplished during this past dynamic and truly unprecedented year. I know that you're probably sick and tired of hearing those words, but it doesn't mean that it isn't true. Your perseverance, determination, and grace this past year is truly exemplary. I can't wait to hear all about your future successes. Congratulations again, class of 2021. Way to go.
Congratulations, MSBA class of 2021. It's been an interesting year, and I was honored to be your instructor for management science and especially honored to work with the winning team for Ingram Micro Capstone Project. Have a great summer, everybody.
Hi, everyone. My name is Tiam Shitayashi. I'm in the full-time MBA graduating class of 2021, as well as the last year's MSA president. Now, on behalf of MSA, I had one last parting gift for all of us. I've asked two people to kind of give some parting words and encouragement on our special day. You might recognize one of them or both of these familiar faces, but I'll let them take it from here. Guys?
Hello to the Mirage graduate class of 2021. Congratulations to all of you. I hear you have graduated from UC Irvine with your master's degrees. You know what that means to me? You're smarty pants. That's right. Congratulations. This is huge. That's what she said. You've done it. And so now I wish you a lifetime, a future ahead, filled with continued academic rigor, filled with love, filled with success, filled with laughter, but most importantly, filled with chili. Nice.
Pau Gasol here, wishing you congratulations, all the class of the Mirage, graduate class of 2021. Congrats on graduating. Congrats on the great accomplishment. Wishing you the best on the next chapter of your lives, of your professional careers. Hope you love what you decide to do, which will make you put in the work, pursue it, and accomplish great things, and enjoy it. Enjoy that ride. All the best to you guys. Congrats again. Wishing you the best, like I said, and just try to be the best that you can be, whatever you choose to do. And enjoy, like I said, enjoy the journey, enjoy every step. Don't take the easy way. Usually all things in life that are worth and are valuable, they require hard work, they require sacrifice and discipline. So all the best to you guys again, and congrats. Enjoy today.
Punamahuja.
I want to thank God in the form of my family, friends, faculty, and mentors who have supported me all the way through. We finally made it! Yeah!
Vincentia Angelica. Salem Arthur. Sight by Kirti Bulgot. Mariana Carini. Sammy Chung. Dido Chung. Isha Chaudhary. Eric Chen.
Hello everyone, my name is Eric Chen. I'm from 2021 MSBA class. Peace, guys.
Chia Jo Chen. Sung Yu Chen. Kevin Chung. Anthony Choi. Edward Chung. Darshana Daga. Sujaya Dark. Miradaya. Marielle de la Cruz. Ziyu Ding. Yilin Du. Yufang. Haiying Ji. Joshua Ham. Kathy Han.
Congratulations, class of 2021.
Yue Han. Song Han. Being Han. Queen He. Carl Hickel. Ankit Jain. Casey Can. Smitha Kananichael. Misha Khan. Dong Wook Kim. Shefali Kumar. UHSIN Lee. Wenyao Lee. Hyungmin Lee. Changyo Lee. Peggy Lee. William Leonard. Jialu Lee. Sijia Lee. Lexi Lee. Kong Leo. Qingpei Leo. Ping Chuan Leo. Leon Liu. Yvonne Liu. Ying Kai Ma. Susan Mikhail. Alejandra Miramontes. Swathi Midheli. Huey Kwok Nguyen. Derek Nwufo. June Park. Zian Pei. CFAM. Caesar Fawn. Victoria Pinsker. Yiching Chi. Kevin Raja. Matthias Ronau. Brian Sam. Alyssa Schult. Garima Sharma. Yang Sheng.
I'm so happy I graduate.
Be a yeah! Zimong Song. Lokesh Nandani Sood.
I'm graduating. I want to thank my family, my friends, my husband, my niece.
Meishi Sun. Nayab Saida. Parsa Thomasebi. Azin Vahanian. Herschel Vaza. Yashmini Vapu. Zihaya Wong. Yuyang Wong. Lu Wong. Yuching Wong. Jiangshan Wong. Chingwu Wang. Yifan Wu. Jean Wei Wu. Hong Jia Su. Ming Long Su. Meng Xiu.
For all my family, friends, and the teachers' support. It's a tough year, but we did it.
Bowen Yang. Yichen Yao. Daniel Yi. Justin Young. Winnie Zing Yu. Zian Zhang. Haoren Zheng. Xinyan Zhu.
Hello, graduating class of 2021, and congratulations. You've toughed out a really difficult COVID year, and I'm sure you're ready to move on. You have worked very hard, and you've done it to prepare yourself to become a future leader in our new economy. And I think the next 10 years is going to be a very crucial period of time for you, because that will determine where you're going to land, who you're going to be, and what is your path to the future. So it seems to me like it's very important to ask a question, which is, what will the next 10 years be like? Well, let me share my prediction with you. I think it's going to be stormy, fast changing, and very unpredictable. Let me try to explain. By way of background, I should say that I chair three companies within the Mirage Investment Group, which we call MIG for short. There's a hedge fund group, there is a private equity group, and a real estate investment group. So my number one job in this multi-billion dollar enterprise is to figure out what's coming around the corner. And why? Why is that so important? It's because in a very fast-changing environment, it is so important for us to stay competitive by being at the very front edge of what is happening out there. And at the very front edge of any changes in technology that is happening. So we all know that our economy is going through a major change. It's going from the old industrial economy to a new knowledge economy. And during that past 10, 12 years, we know that some huge monster companies have been created from this new knowledge economy. And some segments in our economy have been almost devastated, such as retail. What a lot of people are not really focused on now, though, is what the next 10 years is about to bring. And I think the next 10 years is going to be a period of change and super steroids. Why is that? I think it's because two really major technological developments, which is artificial intelligence and quantum computing, are going to come together and join the foundation, the base that is there, and make a huge difference in everything, every aspect of our economy. So I think by some estimates, about a third of the S&P companies today are not going to exist in 10 years. Think about that. That's huge. Millions of jobs are going to be altered in a significant way or eliminated altogether. Some of them may be yours. So I have to stop and say, I know what you're thinking. You're saying, well, is this, Paul, is this a message of congratulations, or are you just trying to scare the hell out of us? So what I'm saying is that essentially, yes, it is a warning, but I would like for us to concentrate on the opportunities this will present. Please don't forget that every time change destroys the old, it provides opportunities for new and for opportunities for new businesses. It could be not new opportunities for new enterprises, from small to very large. And this is the thing to focus on. But you do need to know where to look. So, and I know right now you're probably ready to chuck all the books, all the assignments, and say, to hell with all of this, I'm done. and take a breather. And it's quite understandable. But after you get a rest, please do this. Roll up your sleeves and start becoming very familiar with every new technology that is coming along. Keep tabs on all of these developments. Ask yourself, what will that mean for my organization, for my company? What will it mean for me? And most importantly, what opportunities will it represent? This is how you will be a leader in tomorrow's future. And the winners and the losers are going to be the ones who are proactive versus reactive. It's as simple as that. So also watch for convergences happening. The one thing that is for sure is that most of the time what will impact you is not coming at you in a straight line. It is through a zigzag of two or three different technologies converging and making possible things that none of them individually could have made possible. So that's a very important thing to keep in mind. But allow me to suggest an excellent book, which I read and enjoy, and I think could be a starting point for you to dig into. It's called The Future is Faster Than You Think. And it's by, the author is Peter Diamandis, Peter is a serial entrepreneur, which is very closely tied to the various movers and shakers in Silicon Valley. And I think you'll find the book to be quite interesting. So I'm going to close with an old Chinese proverb, which I found in a fortune cookie. It says, luck is when opportunity meets preparation. So I wish you a great deal of luck. Thank you for listening.
And this brings us to a conclusion of our virtual commencement ceremony this morning. I hope that everyone has enjoyed the ceremony and that you all have fun activities planned for the rest of the day. Now that many of us are vaccinated and are able to gather, I hope that you are able to spend the day with those loved ones that have provided you with support as you've gone through this degree. Relax, take a day off. Trust me, you've earned it. Now, this is not goodbye. It's called a commencement because it is the commencement of the relationship that you have with us going forward as an alum of the Mirage School of Business. Certainly, we want you to stay connected. We want to celebrate your accomplishments going forward, but also be a support for you as you take on new challenges in your career. So on behalf of the faculty and the staff of the Paul Mirage School of Business, congratulations again on this amazing achievement. Zot, zot, zot.